Good morning. I want to welcome each of you to Hasty Baptist Church. Today is a little different. Today we are doing our first online service, and as you can tell, there's very few to no one here today. But we wanted to share one with another and share the Word of God. This morning I want to read you a verse. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Today we're here to worship God. Today we're together in one accord. We as one body stand on the solid rock of Jesus Christ. We will not live in fear. Jesus said he will never leave us nor forsake us. We claim these scriptures today. Only he can give us peace during these trying times. Got a couple announcements I need to make. One, there will be no Wednesday night programs here at the church as of now. We will have online Bible study on Facebook. Please keep one another in your prayers. Also, a couple prayer requests. We'll get to here in a few minutes, but first and foremost, again, I want to welcome each and every one of you. See several folks are starting to come online. Thank you for joining us today. At this time, we're going to have Chase Ramey to come up and to play a song for us. Thank you, Chase and Doyle. Greatly appreciate that. This time we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. We have a couple of prayer requests we want to make you aware of. Myra Russell, she'll be having surgery Tuesday at Duke University. Please keep her in your prayers. Please continue to pray that she's able to have the surgery and that everything will go according to God's will. Also, continue to remember our community, our families, those that are around us during this COVID-19 pandemic, especially the elderly and the medically at risk. If you have prayer requests this week, if you will, send them to me. Let me know by email or text or call, or you can respond on this video here, and we'll be happy to get those out and let folks know to pray for one another, because it's one of the most important things that we can do for each other during this time is to pray for one another. At this time, we'll go to the Lord in prayer. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for your mercy and your grace. Lord, I thank you for each and every one that has tuned in today, Father. Lord, that we are one body and one core, seeking to serve you any way possible, Lord. Lord, I pray during this time that you give us peace and understanding that it only comes from you, Father. And Lord, allow us to understand and to know that we don't have to understand everything. We don't have to understand why and how this happened. All we have to understand is that you are in complete control and that you will see us through. You promised us that you'll never leave us nor forsake us and that you will always be with us. Lord, just be with us today. Lord, we lift up the request that's on our hearts. Lift up the ones that are not here today, Father. The ones that are at home that would love to be in the house of God, that would love to be worshiping together in one accord, side by side. But you know, no matter what comes against us, you're always for us. And Lord, we lift you up that you may receive honor and glory through this service today. Lord, just be with us, guide us, and direct us. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, we ask these things. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a special song for you guys. Unprecedented times, with things that are going on around us that have never happened in my lifetime, and most of your lifetime. But one thing that's the same, that's never changed, Jesus is in control.
Right.
He has everything, you and me, in his hands. All we have to do is choose to follow him, choose to put trust in him. And one of the things that I want to address this morning through Scripture is we don't have anything to fear. We don't have to be afraid. We don't have to live in fear. We don't have to act in fear. All we have to do is choose to follow Christ and to live in Christ. If you will, let's look at the 23rd Psalms, starting at verse 1. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil in the house of the Lord forever. When we read this scripture, it's one of the most quoted scriptures of all time. One of the things that I want to share with you this morning, we're going to go through this verse by verse, and we're going to look at it and see what God has to say. King David is the author of this psalm. He wrote this for you and I. He uses an analogy of a shepherd in the field with his flock to show us the relationship that we have with God. You see, God is our shepherd. He keeps us safe. He watches over us. He protects us. And when we wander away or wander astray, God brings us in. He uses that staff and that rod not only to discipline us, but to save us from harm. This morning, I want us to see who we are in Christ. I want us to see how we are living in these days. I also want us to see what the Lord is trying to tell us. I believe that God tells us several things in Scripture. One, that I believe is very relevant right here, right now, today. In 2 Chronicles, he tells us that if we don't listen to him, I'm paraphrasing, if we don't listen to him, and we don't follow him, there will be plagues. There will be other things that is released on this earth. And if we'll only turn to him, turn back to him, focus on God, the Father, through the Son, he will remove those things from us. Before we go through these verses, let me share something real fast with you. As a nation, we have strayed away from God. As communities, we have strayed away from God. And I believe, unfortunately, even as churches, we have strayed away from God. Maybe this is God's way of bringing us back to him. Maybe this is God's way of pulling us back in and allowing us to see that we are to be still and know that he is God. In verse 1, Psalms 23. If the Lord is our shepherd, as it states, that means he will meet our needs. All we have to do is to follow him. You know, I went to the grocery store the other day. I went to Walmart, actually. It was a mistake. I just needed a couple of things. I walked up, people coming out with two or three baskets full of stuff. One person. They're living in fear. You walk in, the shelves are clean. Well, Pastor, you don't know what's going to happen over the next few weeks. You're right, I don't. But I do. God's in control, and he's going to take care of me. And he's going to watch over me and my house because we're going to choose to follow him. Let me give you some scripture that backs that up. Matthew 6, verse 33. It's one of my favorite verses in the Bible. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and he shall add all these things unto you. Pastor, what does that mean? You got to look in context. You got to go back and read the chapter. He talks about the birds of the air. He talks about them having plenty of food. He talks about the lilies of the valley being clothed in such splendor that not even Solomon had. And he also talks about if he can clothe the lilies of the valley, if he can feed the fowls of the air, he can definitely clothe you and feed you. So trust in him. Don't trust in yourself. If we truly seek God first and allow him to be our shepherd, listen to what I just said. If we truly seek God first and allow him to be our shepherd, he will provide for us. He will take care of our needs. He will provide no matter what. It doesn't matter if there's any toilet paper at Walmart. It doesn't matter if there's any food at Walmart. It doesn't matter what's at Food Lion. It doesn't matter what's wherever. If we trust God, he will make sure we have what we need at all times. Notice I said need, not want. There's a difference. Look in verse 2 and 3, if you will. It talks about how our soul is restored. He restores our soul. How? By making us lie down in green pastures and leading us beside still waters. Let me explain something to you. Very simply, the last few days, I've seen things I haven't seen in years. I've seen neighbors out that I haven't seen outside in years, if ever, since they've lived there. I've seen parents playing with their kids. I've seen people walking the neighborhoods. I've seen people out here at the church. Out here playing basketball on the goal. I've seen them everywhere I go, uniting together as a family. That is some good and this bad, isn't there? Think about it. Well, Pastor, we don't have anything else to do. That's probably one of the most important things we should be doing. Notice it said in verse 2, he makes me to lie down in green pastures. Pastures not always greener on the other side of the fence. We need to be thankful for what we have. We need to enjoy what God has given us and the family that he has given us. Beside the still waters, the Word of God. Everlasting water that will never thirst again. Maybe we can use this time to get into the Word. Maybe we can use this time to draw closer to Him. And maybe that's what He wants us to do. Maybe that's why He has allowed this to happen. Because this didn't happen without God knowing that was going to happen. We need to understand that. He's allowed it to happen for a reason. And that reason, I believe, is to draw His children back closer to Him. You see, when Jesus was getting ready to leave this earth and ascend into heaven, he told his disciples, I will not leave you as orphans. I will send a comforter. He will never leave us nor forsake us. And he's not going to leave us alone. That's why we have the Holy Spirit in the form of the comforter. During these times. And I want to ask you something. Have you relied on the Holy Spirit? Have you went to Jesus in prayer? And have you sat and listened? Not just, Lord, what am I going to do? I don't know what I'm going to do with the kids. I don't know what I'm going to do for food. I don't know what I'm going to do 3 months down the road. God doesn't promise us tomorrow, but he gives us today. Understand that. We need to live in today. Doesn't mean we don't need to plan. Doesn't mean we don't need to look ahead. But it does mean we should not worry about what God has in store for us, because he will protect us whether here are at the feet of Jesus. We are in his will and need to live in his will. You see, we need to restore the soul of our communities. We need to restore the soul of our country. And I believe we need to restore the soul of our churches, that we do act in one accord, seeking him in all things. Let's look at verse 4, if you will. He talks about the rod. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Right now, a lot of folks believe we're walking through the valley of the shadow of death. And it feels that way, doesn't it? And to some, it is. Understand that this COVID-19 is real. And that people are dying from it. People are not just getting extremely sick, they're also dying. It is a real thing. However, my God is a real, not a thing. He's not a thing. He's my everything. He is real. And he will take care of us. The rod is used to get the sheep's attention. It's a gentle reminder or a nudge for them to go in the right direction. When they start to stray away, he uses the rod to push them. And you know, we've had the rod used on us over and over again. And some of us have gotten so used to being hit with the rod, we ignore it. We don't pay any attention anymore. We're not listening to what God has for us. The staff, a little different from the rod. The staff is used in a couple of different ways. First, it's used to walk with. Our lives are a lot like the shepherds. And it's a lot like the sheep. The shepherd and sheep live on the hillside most of the time. And they go up and down, grazing, wherever they can go. And occasionally, a sheep gets lost, and the shepherd has to go get him. Occasionally, the sheep falls into the briar patches, falls into the thorns, falls into the world, if you will, using the church analogy. And the shepherd has to go and take the hook on that staff, reach down and grab them and pull them up back to safety. You know, that's what Jesus does to us. We spend most of our time, most of our lives, not on the mountaintops and not even in the valleys, but in between, going from one to the other. And I want you to see something here. Sometimes we lose sight of what's important and we veer off of that path. And as we go off of that path, the shepherd comes behind us and he pokes us with the rod. If we continue to ignore him. And then we continue to get further and further away from God. So what happens? Eventually we fall into a pit. We fall into a briar patch. We fall into sin. But then when we come to our senses and we cry out, Lord, save me. The shepherd comes by with that hook, Jesus Christ, and he pulls us out, and he sets us on the straight and narrow. Today I believe that we need to cry out, Lord, save me, not just for us, but for our country, for each other. We need to intercede for one another. In closing, let's look at verses 5 and 6. If you know Christ as your Savior, he has gone to prepare a place for you. John 14:2 states, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you so. I go to prepare a place for you. As God's children, as brothers and sisters in Christ, we know that Jesus has gone to prepare a place for us. So why are we living in fear? We have no reason to. We can live in the safety and the love of God's outstretched arms. Because he's going to protect us. He's going to take care of us. As we close today, I want to share a couple of things. One, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you have reason to fear. But it's not COVID-19. It's not the coronavirus. It's not whatever you want to call it. The fear should be that you're going to live eternity in hell if you don't accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. It's that simple. There's only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus Christ. But I'm not going to leave you hanging this morning. I'm going to tell you how to do that. It's simple. All you have to do is to admit that you've sinned before God, that you have fallen, that you've made mistakes. But Pastor, you don't understand what I've done. I've done so many bad things. I can't come to God until I get some things right in my life. God comes to right where you are. Plain and simple. He comes to right where you are. Two, believe that Jesus came, born as a baby to a virgin named Mary. He lived a life that was sin-free. He was tempted like you and I, but he never sinned. He never failed. Then he was killed. Understand what I said? Killed. Because of our sins. Because of what we've done. But he rose again on the third day so that you and I may have eternal life in heaven with the Father. If you want to know Jesus as your Lord, all you have to do is ask. Take the time right here, right now, online, and ask Jesus to forgive you of your sins. Then let me know. It's that simple. We can look at Scripture. I'll be happy to talk to you. You can call me, text me. I'll be happy to meet you. The most important thing you can do today is make sure that you're right with Jesus Christ. That's it. Two. For us that know Jesus as our Lord and Savior, don't let doubt in. Don't let Satan come in and rob you of the joy that Christ has given you. Pastor, you just don't know what I'm facing. And I've heard that in my own household. I've heard that in my own family. I've heard that with people that I'm closer to than a brother. We're all facing the same thing. We're all facing the same crisis. The difference is we don't all have the same peace. That's peace from the Lord. This morning as we pray, I want to challenge you to give it all to Jesus. Let us pray. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Lord, we thank you for your mercy and your grace. We thank you for allowing us to gather together, Father. Lord, it's a little different than normal, and that's okay. You want us to come out of our comfort zones. You want us to serve you and to be just and to be faithful. And this morning, I believe that we have. I believe that we are striving to do what is right because it is right. Lord, I lift up those that are watching us online. Lord, if there's anyone that has accepted you as Lord and Savior today, we give you all the glory. Lord, if there are those that are struggling to accept you and just can't let go of self to embrace you, I pray that today is the day that they turn it all over to you. Right here, right now. Lord, for your children, for me, my family, Hasty Baptist Church, our church family, Hasty community, Thomasville, North Carolina, the state of North Carolina, the United States and the world, Lord, I pray that we all seek you and we turn our faces back to you. And Lord, that if it's your will, you will remove this plague from us. And Lord, that we will truly seek you in all things. Lord, just be with us through this week. Guide us and direct us. In the name of Jesus, we ask these things. Amen. Thank you guys for being with us. At this time, we're going to close services. We'll see you again on Wednesday night. Hope y'all have a blessed week. Keep a check on our Facebook page. We will have live updates each day, different things such as interviews and maybe some music here and there. Please keep a check on us. And if you need anything, please reach out to me 24 hours, 7 days a week. Y'all have a blessed day in the Lord.